Acts of Apostle chapter 3, verses 1 to 5. The book of the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3, verses 1 to 5. Somebody said that that book of Acts of the Apostles was demonstration of the Holy Spirit in action in the lives of people. Probably we should call it the act of the Holy Spirit. Because Holy Spirit was the one that the book was all about. In fact, the whole Bible is about the Holy Spirit. But when you look at the book of the Acts of the Apostles, you cannot but see the acts of the Holy Spirit. And that is what you are experiencing right now. And that is what you will experience today.
Amen.
Now Peter and John went up together to the temple at the hour of prayer, the night hour. That's about 3 p.m. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms from those who entered the temple. Verse 3, who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked for alms. Beggars will always beg. That is what they have been told to do. That is what they were born to do. But when God comes into the life of a beggar, that person stopped begging because he found a life in God. If you are begging God, you will find life in God. And you will stop begging. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. But importantly, see the life of this man who started as a beggar. Verse 4. And fixing his eyes on him with John, Peter said, look at us. So he gave them his attention, expecting to receive something from them. Fixing his eyes on him with John, Peter said, look at us. That means that attention was first started by Peter. Peter wanted to get this attention of this man. Peter fixed his eyes on him and said, look at us. Focus in life, focus from two people must balance each other. An effective communication is one whereby when you are talking to somebody, you look into each other's faces. True of us. That's an effective communication. If somebody began to talk to me and began to talk and look elsewhere, what will come to your mind? He or she is fibbling, is lying. You see? So, for an effective communication, therefore, I've been brought up to know you look into people's eyes. That is it. So, the people communicating must have focus. Otherwise, there's no communication. So, beginning from Peter, therefore, and John, fixing his eyes on him with John, said, look at us. A lot of us are not looking at God. We are looking elsewhere. And that is why there has been no advancement. More importantly, in this month that we are looking at advancement, what are those things that have made people to be tied down? If you looked last week about long-term conditions, or week before the last week we'll look at if you can believe. But most long-term conditions, not that God did not know about it. God knows about it. So many a time when we are thinking that God do something, God was actually waiting on us to do something, as we have discussed in our previous discussion. But today we are looking at this focus. There's a relationship between your attention and your expectation. And that's what I want us to look at. And once this attention and there's disparity between attention and expectation, it tends to delay you. It tends to delay us in our advancement. May you not be delayed anymore.
Amen.
Verse 5. So he gave them his attention. Who gave them his attention? The crippled man. So that means that all along, his attention was not there. True? Because until Peter told him, look at us, the scripture now says, in response, the man gave them his attention. That supposes that before now, even though the man was there, but his attention was not there. And that is what I'm saying, that many a times, one of the reasons why we have delays in life is because of misplaced attention. One of the reasons why we have delays in life, not that we don't pray, not that we don't fast, not that we are not proper Christian, is that we are not, our attention is not on God. Our attention is on something else. So it is possible, therefore, to be in church, yet not in church, true or false. It's possible for you to be hearing me right now, but you are not actually listening to me. So we are looking at this one, because there are the reasons why we can have delays in life. Same way, it is possible to be hearing from God, but not listening. Two different things. Until you listen to what you hear, you have no reason to receive. Until you listen to what you hear, you have no reason to receive. So he gave them his attention, our attention, their attention, your attention, attention, everybody has attention. The problem is what we do with the attention. So he gave them his attention. You may be here right now. I'm begging you to give me your attention. Don't put your attention elsewhere, because it's possible to be here but not here. So he gave them his attention, expecting to receive. Can you see the relationship between attention and expectation? Not until he gave them his attention, he had no good reason to receive anything. He had no justification to expect to receive. That means that there is something about your expectation that has to do with your attention. It's not that you don't pray. It's not that you don't fast. It's not that you don't read the Bible. But what do you do with your attention? What can make your attention to strengthen your expectation and give it the right reason, a strong reason to receive something, expectation to receive something? That's what we're looking at. So everyone has attention ability. True? Everyone has attention ability. If you have attention ability, then you have strong reasons to receive from God. But why are people not receiving? That's what we are looking at. One area you have to work on if you want to advance in life is in your attention ability with God. Some people say sensitivity. We talk a lot about it this morning in our Bible study. You need to be sensitive to the move of God. You need to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. You need to be blind to what happens around you and be sighted. Open your eyes to what goes on within you. Because what goes on within you, it's more important to God, not what goes on around. What goes on around is distraction. And devil is the architect, chief architect of destruction. So one of the problems of Christians today, or one of the problems Christians face today, that stops us in our tracks, is the problem of attention. And that's make the difference between making it or not making it. Amen?
Amen.
For the rest of this year, therefore, we are just in October going to the end. We start preparing for our New Year resolution now. For what is going to happen next year. It is hypocritical doing your New Year resolution on the 1st of January. Because you will never do it. It is now, as we are towards the tail end of preceding year that God will challenge you. And that's where your attention ability comes in. Especially when you are alone. I love spending time alone. I love locking up myself. When I do that, I listen attentively. It is time that God begins to tell you how your life will be next year. How your career, how your family, how your job, how your health, what's going to happen to you? People that fail to plan to fail. It is time. Turn someone and say, it is time.
It is time.
The same way I'm talking to you is the same way I listen to God for next year. And God gave me the themes, different themes of the year. God tells me what and what will happen to each of you, and I pray for you. Some fall out, some stay. You will not fall out.
Amen.
So for the rest of this year, therefore, your attention ability is so crucial to how you end this year. It will be tested. It will decide if you finish well. And this is why you are here, because I know you will finish well.
Amen.
So let's look on this title, Attention Problems in the Church. Attention Problems in the Church, or rather, BAD, Believers Attention Disorders. Bad. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Believers Attention Disorders. It has to do with what I have noticed over the years about the problem of attention that many of the Christians I know, even pastors I have met, what they faces. So that's why we're looking at this BAD, Believers Attention Disorders, or attention problems in the church. The church is the place to fix problems, isn't it? Yes, the church is just like an hospital. It's not everybody that comes in the hospital that are well. Otherwise, who is going to treat them? And also, it's not everyone that comes to the church that is well. Otherwise, what would be their testimony? You know, we have people coming to church because of sickness, and then God healed them, and then they testify, isn't it? So that means that the hospital is just like the church, and the church is just like the hospital. We have people that are sick, we have people that are well, we have people that treat them, and this is where God comes in. So I don't know which side of the spectrum you are, but whatever side of the spectrum you are, that is hopeful.
Amen.
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 Misplaced attention will delay your expectation. Misplaced attention is one area the devil has been using and is still using against many believers in Christ. You wonder why some people started very well, but along the way. The other time, the brother was asking me in the parable of the weeds. Said the enemy came to plant it, the devil. So if the brother said, if we have been doing our work properly, why would the devil come in? Hallelujah.
Amen.
So attention is very important. You know, many a time that's why I always plead on you. Look at me. Because this is where the power is. He said, out of Zion shall flow. Shall flow what? Power. So this is where the power is. And of course, for the power to flow to you, it cannot flow to you when you have a misplaced attention. So that's why I'm pleading. And devil is very good in that area. Many of the Christians today that we know, they started very well, but along the way, they got distracted because they were looking at other things. So misplaced attention, therefore, is one of the reasons why there will be delay in advancement. But today we are going to deal with that. You will no longer be delayed.
Amen.
Misplaced attention is one area the devil is using against every believer, including pastors, every believer in Christ. And you see, that is why towards the end of this year now, that I'm telling you to take a close look about what have you achieved in 2015, Yes, some of it you have not really achieved, but some of it you have. What can I do to achieve the ones that I have not? Is there something I am not doing? You see, and that's why I prayed with you when we were doing the Bible story. I spoke the word of God to some of us, because that's what God said to tell you. You have to begin to focus properly, and so that you can know whether you're on track or not. And unfortunately, there are attention problems, as I've said, in our church. So at the end of today, therefore, not only will you be healed of BAD, believers' attention disorders, by the end of today, teaching, you have strong reason to receive from God. Amen? You have strong reason to receive from God. So when he gave them his attention, he was now expecting to receive from them. He was now expecting to receive from them. Not until this man gave them his attention, he has no expectation to receive anything from them. For a point of warning, don't give without expectation. He said, give and it shall be given to you. So when you give, expect that it shall be given to you. Not the same way you have given, but more than what you have given. So when you give to God, expect a return. Don't give because of return's sake. Give because you choose to obey God. That's what matters. Because when you obey God, God will honor your obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Believers' attention disorders. Today I look at many so-called Christians. They're doing everything, but they're not doing everything well. And more of it is what you do when you leave the church. More of it is what you do at home when you are alone. I've seen Christians, I've fought with them, and I said, no, you don't live a double life. You have to do what you do here on Sunday, you have to do the same at home. You see? And that's why I shout at some people, because the zeal of God is real. When Jesus Christ met the people doing exchange of money in the house of God, was he gentle with them? No, he shouted at them. And the people said, the zeal of God has consumed him. How do you know about the zeal of God in your life? How do you know what you see when people are not giving God the honor? I don't know how you cope when people are swearing or saying something that is nasty about God. God expects you to defend him. Not to fight them, but to speak the word of God. It's better for you to lose friends than to lose God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Attention problems. Verse 9. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Verse 10. Then they knew that it was he who sat begging alms at the beautiful gates of the temple. Did the man advance?
Yes.
But can you retrace what he did for him to advance? We are told that this man was over 40 years. We are told that this man was carried daily by men. So for over 40 years, he had no other business but to beg until God came in. God is coming to your life today.
Amen.
His story changed for good. Your story will change for good.
Amen.
But what took him that long? Hello? What took him that long? If I say to you, attention problems took him. Attention problems. You see, God knew your condition. God knows that your condition has been there for a long time. I want to challenge you for the rest of this month, for the rest of this year. If you can place your attention in God and do what it requires, you will finish well. You see, the vision you saw is real. The images you saw about your life is genuine. Devil cannot give you because the devil doesn't like you. Amen?
Amen.
It's beautiful. If I were you, I would embrace it. So the heroes of faith, they were looking for a city. They saw it, and that kept them going. Abraham, before Abraham became the father of Isaac, he saw what God said, that he will become the father of many nations. God told him in Genesis 12, and Abraham was walking in that faith. Even when Abraham was old, over 100 years, he was still expecting God, and God honored him. Even when Sarah, his wife, has gone past the stage of menopause, when biologically, medically, it's not possible to become a mother. Because God said so, Abraham and Sarah became parents. How long has yours taken you? If you can look at what has been taking your attention, I'm telling you, if you can trace that and replace that attention now in God and begin to walk in that direction, you have every right to expect to receive God from God, and you will receive from God.
Amen.
If you don't start giving God your attention, your expectation will be weak. Psalm 84 verse 7. Psalm 84 verse 7, our sister used to pray on Friday, says, they go from strength to strength. I love that. Each one appears before God in Zion. That tells me, if it is you that is always appearing before God, if your attention is always in God, because there is no way you can appear before God when your attention is elsewhere. So if your attention is always before God, and if your attention is in God, advancement is not a possibility, it is real. It is certain. Because the scripture says, a possibility is something that is likely. No, this one is assured. He said, they go from what? Strength to strength. Is that not advancement? You will advance.
Amen.
If only your attention can be properly placed in God. They go from strength to strength. Each one, I love it. Including you. Including you. Not including you. Everyone has the right to advance. Everyone that has given God his attention will advance.
Amen.
But the problem is, you give God attention today, and the next minute you took it away. And then that's the cause of delay. When you give God your undivided attention, expect to go forward in strength. That's the meaning of that scripture. You cannot dwindle in life. You cannot. But where your attention is divided from God, it stops you in your track. And that is the reason why that situation remains. John chapter 5, very quickly. Are you getting something? John chapter 5, verse 6. When Jesus saw him lying there, and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, do you want to be made well? You're familiar with this story, because we have taught on this several times. We now know that Jesus asked this question to get this man's attention. Because all along, this man's attention was not in Christ. This man's attention was not in Christ. So Jesus Christ came to him and specifically asked this question so that he can get his attention. It's not every time God will ask you if you want to be healed, especially if you already knew you have been sick for a long time. Every time he asks you that, it's because you are not doing something he expected to do. Hello? He has this man in order to get his attention. Bible teaching is good because what God will do is there. God will not do anything outside His word. God is so reliable, so faithful, so dependable. God does not compromise. Whatever His word says, that's exactly what He will do. So I'm telling you now the secret of God. Reliability of God. Dependability of God. Unchangeability of God. Look at it. If this man's attention has been in God, would Christ have come to him to ask him, do you want to be made well? No. So, he asked this man, because he knew that this man has been in that condition, yet nothing has worked. Can you identify what I'm talking about? Verse 7. The sick man answered, sir, I have no man to put me into the pool. Doesn't this sound like an attention problem? True or false? Hello?
Hello.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
Doesn't this sound like an attention problem?
Yes.
The man has been there in that condition for how many years? 38 years. Everyone else but him was healed. Jesus Christ saw him lying there. Jesus Christ had to come to him and ask him, I've seen you lying down there for some time. Do you really want to be made whole? Now, let's see whether he has an attention problem or not. He would have said yes. But look at what he said. Sir, I have no man to take me. Was that the question? Jesus did not ask him if he needed someone to carry him. Was that the question? But how come this man answered Jesus that way? That's the same picture of many of us. While we are waiting for God to do the impossible, God was waiting for us to also do what He has told us to do. So, the problem now is when there's a disparity between attention and expectation, you aren't going anywhere. Until every one of us can use his attention properly in God so that his expectation can be strengthened, then you have justification to receive from God. Amen.
Amen.
Am I boring you?
No.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm just helping somebody here. Believers' attention disorders. Do you have an attention problem? Let the doctor heal you. Dr. Jesus. Everyone has attention, but not everyone has attention disorders. What do you do with your attention? How come we are still in that situation? I kept asking myself, the things I want to be done, why is it taking me time, Lord? And God will speak to me. And that's why I'm asking you, do you have an attention disorder? The problem with many believers today, we assume to know what God is saying, but we never get the grip of exactly what He's saying. That was what the problem of this man. Just asking a sincere question, do you want to be made whole? Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool. If he missed it because of attention problem. See, he assumed that God knows that I've been in this condition for long. So why is God not doing something? But that's the question. God has given you the ability to refocus your attention properly. Mark chapter 5 verse 29. Mark chapter 5 verse 29. Immediately, the fountain of her blood, you know what I'm talking about, was dried up. And she felt in her body that she was healed. That was a woman with 12 years. Of bleeding problem. The scripture says, immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up. How long did it take her for the bleeding to stop? How long did it take her for the bleeding to stop? No. I didn't say how long was her condition for.
Immediately.
You see that? Attention. How long did it take the bleeding to stop? Immediately, no time. But how long did it take that condition for?
12 minutes.
Hallelujah. Verse 25. Now a certain woman had a flow for 12 years. Now you know how long the condition was. Verse 26. And had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all, and her condition was no better. Attention disorders. Because all along, where was her attention? In physicians. Because she has a lot of money. You can see how, why the rich will always cry. Yeah. Because she had money, she was better than God. But many people feel that it's only poor people that need God anyway. But they are wrong. We all need people. We all need God, brother. Amen?
Amen.
The rich and the poor need God. Amen? How many people need God here? I need God. That's why I'm here. Praise God. Our attention was not in God, but in doctors. And so God could not do anything. God had to leave her alone. So she started with a lot of goods, money. Then she ended up with nothing. Then suddenly, our attention now said, oh, I think I've been wrong. Let me place my attention in God. So it's not too late. Talk to someone and say it's not too late.
It's not too late.
Look at verse 27. How will you place your, who you put your attention upon, or on, who you put your attention on, whether God or something else, is seen in how you live your life daily. The moment you open your eyes from your bed, before you say good morning, your attention ability will be tested. Verse 27, when she heard about, scripture says, when she had about, in fact, this one says, when she had heard, I love the King James Bible, it said, when she had heard of Jesus, she came. That doesn't tell me that that was the first time she heard about Jesus. She must have heard about Jesus before, and she didn't come. Until when she had nothing. Now, in a messed up condition, suddenly, the news about Jesus came, and everything came flashing to her. And so, she needed to do something fast because of Jesus' news. When she had heard of Jesus, she came in the press. She came with a determination. She came because now her attention is on who? Jesus. So she came with an attention on Jesus, an expectation on Jesus. Verse 27, 28. For she said in her mind, right now, see where your attention workshop is, your mind. That's why when you wake up in the morning, your test begins there, where you place your attention. She said, when did she say that? Verse 28. She said, if only I may talk is good. When did she say that?
At home.
In her mind. She refocused her attention. I know I've messed up. Now, I want to come back to God. Devil is using that against many believers. He's working on your mind. And how can you defeat the devil? Through the word of God. Remind yourself constantly about what God has said. That was the secret of this woman. She had heard about Jesus. Her mind began to come back home. And then she said to herself, she trained her mind on what to think of. She said, if only I can touch, if only I may touch his food, I shall be made well. So she did. And immediately, in no time, her blood dried up. And she could feel in her body that she was what? Well. So that means that you can feel whether that healing is taking place or not. Especially when your attention has been placed on God. Let me round up with this. Everyone's attention can be put right, true of us. Every one of us will be given the chance, the opportunity to put our attention right in God. So it's not late if you have not been doing it. The word of God you are hearing will help you to put your attention in God's promises. And when you put your attention in God's promises, where will your expectation come from? From God. God has the right. You have the right, rather, to expect to receive from God. Because you've given God your attention. So if you begin to put your attention on God and on His promises from today, then your expectation will become strengthened and realistic. Just wishing to be healed when your attention is elsewhere, you cannot expect to receive from God. Attention and expectation goes together on a daily basis. How can your attention and expectation go together? We'll look at it next time. Let us pray. So Father, we thank you for your word. I know you want to do everything for us to move forward this month, and we shall surely move forward. Lord, it doesn't matter how long we have been tied down in the same condition. But Lord, we have found out from the Lord that you have our best interest in that. Therefore, Lord, we are asking you, wherever we have missed, we have misplaced our attention, whatever we have put our attention on apart from God, Lord, forgive us. Amen. Give us another opportunity. Amen. We need to train our mind. We need to put our attention only on God and on His promises. Therefore, Lord, we are asking you, whoever is ready out there, I have discovered his or her fault. I have discovered that his attention or attention has been wrongly placed. And they want sincere to come back home. Just like that woman with the issue of blood decided to come back to Jesus. Lord, I'm asking, give them the repentant heart. And if you are there, you really want to, why don't you ask the Lord to give you another chance? Begin to pray. Why don't you ask Him, Lord, I'm sorry. My attention has been wrongly placed. But now I've found the truth. I'm no longer going to be tied down anymore. My attention will be on you, on your word from now. I will find out from your word what you have said about my condition. And then, as because I have given you my attention, and I've discovered what your promises have said on this condition, my expectation will come from nowhere but from you. Therefore, I have every right to expect to receive from you. Lord, help me. Help me, O God, to place my attention in you. Help me to place my attention in your word. Help me to place my attention in your ability. Before the end of this year, O God, Lord, because my attention is placed in you and my expectation is in you, Lord, I have the right to expect to receive from you. Lord, I pray. Touch that heart of that woman. Touch that heart of that man. Touch that heart of that man that has gone away from you. Touch the heart of the woman that has gone astray from you. And bring back their heart. Bring their heart back to you. Call them back home. Just like the prodigal son came back home. I'm calling them back to Christ. I'm calling them back into relationship. Please surrender your heart to God. Surrender your heart to God right now. Wherever you are, whether watching or listening, surrender your heart to God. Just like that man at the beautiful gate, born crippled, until he gave God his attention, his expectation could not be granted. Until he gave God his attention, his expectation became strengthened And he was now able to expect to receive from God. And no doubt, God honored him. I'm asking you, put your attention only on God. Then your expectation will be strengthened. And because your expectation is strengthened, you have the right to receive from God. And you will receive from God. You will receive from God this month in the name of Jesus. When it happens, testify. When it happens, testify to the glory of God. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Give your heart to Jesus right now and receive from him. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you, O God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, grab this hand together for the Lord.